Hello friends, today we are going to learn about bracket system for the loading on the given beam as in the vertical direction or horizontal direction as shown in the figure. So let us assume the concept behind the bracket system and how to calculate shear force bending moment diagram for given beam with the bracket system. So assume the different types of bracket as shown in the figure, in which first of all, we take the point A, where we assume that the horizontal line as a beam and the point on the A as a vertical column, and in which at the column horizontal load is acting. For example, the value of horizontal load as a 10 kN and vertical column as a 2 meter. If we assume the equilibrium of the system, or we can say that the effect of the same bracket system is indicated in other beam as a equilibrium or resultant of the beam, then for point A, the system bracket indicates that the value of clockwise moment as a 10 into 2 directly act at point A as the horizontal load 10 kN creates the clockwise moment at point A, and the same load is directly acting at point A in the horizontal direction. So, according to the given bracket system, if we provide the equilibrium of the system as the effect of the same bracket by another types of loading, then both the beams are equal. So for the easy calculation, we have to convert our bracket system into point load and moment according to the given condition. So let us take one another example as a B point, in which our vertical column as a 3 meter, horizontal beam on the vertical column as a 1 meter, and the load on the bracket system as a 5 kN. So for these types of loading, this 5 kN of vertical load is directly acting on the point B on the vertical direction, as well as it creates 5 into 1 meter as a clockwise moment on the head of the column, which directly transfers to the point B. It means that at point B, this 5 kN of vertical load is directly acting on beam, as well as 5 into 1 in clockwise direction is acting at a clockwise moment. Now let us take another example of point C, in which if vertical height of the column as a 1.5 meter and load as a 15 kN, then according to point A, this 15 kN is directly acting on point C in horizontal direction, and it creates at point C as a anticlockwise moment, and the value of anticlockwise moment is 15 into 1.5. So at point C, equilibrium beam is 15 in the horizontal direction and 15 as a load and 1.5 meter as a distance for moment. Similar to point D, if vertical load is 20 kN on beam bracket system of 1 meter as a beam and 2 meter as a height of the column, then the 20 kN load is directly acting on D point, and 20 kN load creates the moment over the column head as a 20 into 1 in anticlockwise direction, which directly transfers to point D as kN in anticlockwise direction. Now let us assume one more case as point E, where the height of the column as 2 meter, width of the beam as 3 meter, and on the beam end the horizontal load, which is inclined at 30 degree of 25 kN, is acting. So first of all, when the incline load is given to us, then we have to resolve this incline load into two mutual perpendicular axes as, now the angle is with the horizontal direction, so according to rule it is 25 cos 30 degree, and vertical load as a 25 sin 30 degree. Now after the resolution, we have to ignore the actual loading and we have to convert this bracket system with the help of horizontal as well as vertical loading. So first of all, we take horizontal loading as a 25 cos 30, which is directly transverse to point E. Which creates the clockwise moment at point E having the value as load into perpendicular distance, which is 25 cos 30 into 2 as a clockwise direction. Now assuming the 25 sin 30 load, which is on the vertical direction, hence it transfers directly to point E as a 25 sin 30, and the load creates anticlockwise moment on point E at column head, so it is directly transfers to point E as a anticlockwise moment having the value 25 sin 30 into perpendicular distance as a 3, so 25 sin 30 into 3. Thus we have to first convert the bracket system into the simple beam system, and then we have to solve the simple beam as we solve in different cases. Thank you.